Spurgeon. We all have, as it were, our own ideas of what we want to do, what we think we should do, how we want to be, what we think we want to be, where we want to go, what we think we want to do. And you know, we spend a great part of our life really doing things that don't amount to much, do they? Oh, we may be able to look back and say, oh, well, I went there, I did this. Oh, I went over there, I did that. But you know, in the grand scheme of things, what difference did it make? Was it really that important? What is important to you? What really makes a difference? What gets you up in the morning? What keeps you going? What allows you to experience the fullness of life that God said you could have? Is it, oh, Sunday's coming. Oh, thank God it's Friday. Oh, no, it's a Monday. Oh, you know, it's the end of the month. Oh, it's the beginning of the month. What's driving you? What difference does one day make from another? I know for me, if I wasn't a Christian, if I hadn't found God and God hadn't reached down and touched me and saved me from myself, I'd be dead. You know, there's no doubt about it. I'd be one miserable, poor, suffering sinner that decided to end his life and would be gone. But before all that happened, God chose me to follow him. He promised me not that I would have an exciting life or a boring life. He didn't promise me the riches or the anything. I just went after love, and when I discovered what he had for me, I latched onto it because I knew somehow that that was what was best for me. And oftentimes in my life, I have gotten away from, at certain points in time, doing exactly what God may have said. And I've seen what that does to other people, but then also what it did to me and how it affected me in such a dramatic way that people don't see it. I don't talk much about it. They didn't or weren't aware of it at the time, or they weren't around to see the times I went to God about it and God forgave me, or God cleansed me, or God changed me, or God made me, or God developed me, or God took me through some learning lesson of life that no other way to experience it except that God took me through it and I learned from it. And I discovered in those times that the most important thing that we have in this life really is a personal relationship with God. Because anyone can be religious, and that's nice, you know, it's a nice thing to be because, you know, you can make up these rules and you can follow them and they might keep you from a certain amount of tragedy in your life or travesty, but at some point in time, even rules fail because you run into something that's personal to you. You run into something that goes beyond your rulemaking and deals directly with you in a very intimate way, a very personal way. And when that happens, suddenly your religion comes crashing down and you either find that you don't have a rule to cover it, or you need to uncover the idea that God just might be real, or he's not real in your life. Because if he is real, then you have an assurance, you have a confidence that when you run into those circumstances that aren't covered by your religion or your rules or your faith or whatever circumstances you may run into, when it's not covered, what do you do? Do you run for cover, or do you cry out to God? Because you see, a Christian that knows Jesus doesn't have to cry out to God, but can talk to God daily, and God can prepare them for the time that the rules, the regulations, the religion, the faith, the circumstances just won't fit. And the only thing you can do is trust in the Lord with all your heart, leaning not in your own understanding, in all your ways acknowledging him, and letting him direct you, because you can do nothing else but hold on to him. In Spurgeon, Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel, and afterwards receive me to glory. The psalmist felt his need of divine guidance. He had just been discovering the foolishness of his own heart. Unless he should be constantly led astray by it, he resolved that God's counsel should always now be his guide, for he knew his own folly. A sense of our own foolishness is a great step towards being wise, when it leads us to rely on the wisdom of the Lord as opposed to our own practical common sense. The blind man leans on his friend's arm and reaches home in safety, and so would we give ourselves up implicitly to divine guidance, nothing doubting, assured that though we cannot see, it is always safe to trust the all-seeing God. As the blind man did, could you not, or should you not? Wouldn't it be wise to trust yourself to him who can see, because you cannot? Thou shalt is a blessed expression of confidence. He was sure that the Lord would not decline the condescending task. There is a word for you, O believer. Rest in it. Be assured that your God will be your counselor and your friend. He shall guide you. He will direct your path. It is written in his word that you have this assurance in part fulfilled, for Holy Scriptures is his counsel to you. You have not blind faith, but intelligent faith. In his written word, he has given you that assurance. Happy are we to have God's word always to guide us. What were the mariner without his compass? And what were the Christian without a Bible? This is the unerring chart and the map in which every shoal is described and all the channels from the quicksands of destruction to the haven of salvation, mapped and marked by one who knows all the way. Every way, the way that you should go. Blessed be thou, O God, that we may trust you to guide us now, and guide us even to the end. After this guidance through life, the psalmist anticipates a divine reception at last, and afterward receives me to glory. What a thought for you, believer. God himself will receive you to glory. You, yes, you. Wandering, erring, straying, yet he will bring you safe at last to his glory. This is thy portion, and this is your destiny. Live on in this day, and if perplexity should go around you and surround you, go in the strength of this text straight to the throne of God, and talk with him, for he shall lead you in the way that you should go. Trust also in him, and not only will he bring it to pass, he'll show you the way through, that he might be the one that is your guide always in all things that happen in your life, today and always.